Hi, welcome. This is your resilience flow. We're going to work with that concept today using a cushion and a blanket. Both of those are optional with every class. I do recommend you have them though if it's not too hard for you to get them. So I like to use my blanket to start off with in a folded shape. So I take basically the regular fold that you would fold it and just fold it once again. So it becomes a little bit thicker. Now, depending on the thickness of your blanket or towel, you would place your rib cage onto that surface so that I like to refer to it as the bra line. Basically, the bottom of the shoulder blades are on the edge of that blanket. And you can rest your head on the pillow. Now, if you don't have that, don't worry too much about it. Just lie on your back, place your feet onto the mat, make yourself comfortable here. And then take a moment just to arrive. Arrive in your practice, arrive in your body. And start to become a little bit more aware, a little bit more receptive. Maybe you notice your breath slowing down. Maybe you notice your body kind of releasing, melting a little bit more into the support, the surface. Now, if you feel very uncomfortable, you can always change the blanket. You could always unfold it once or you could move it away. I want you to feel like you could really drape your body onto the surface underneath, into the ground. And as you're witnessing your breath, start to notice if you feel any challenge. Maybe it feels hard for you to breathe. Start to expand the breath. Good. And then start to deepen a little bit more, placing a little bit more energy into the center. Expanding with every inhale, releasing, softening with every exhale. And that is really the rhythm that we're working with today, the idea of strength and flexibility, softness and strength, which is resilience, the ability to recover, to strengthen after any challenge. Start to roll yourself onto your left side for a moment. Notice how that feels. You don't have to go all the way if it's too much. Roll back to center and from center all the way to the right. Again, you can go halfway if this is too much for you today. I want you to feel these little changes of pressure as you're moving from side to side. So you're unfolding towards center and then you're side lying again, you're rolling over. Moving your body from side to side. And then come to lie down on your left. Curl in here, draw your knees together and start to open up the right arm into a twist. Gently rolling over the support, maybe turning your head towards the back hand. And there's a good chance the hand doesn't come quite down. That is fine. As you can see, mine is hovering for a moment. We're not staying for too long. Make sure your shoulders are soft and then bring it back slowly with your exhale. Let your palms touch here. And let's do it one more time. This time, open and swing your knees back up. Good. Just the first little nice opening and roll all the way over to the right. Do the same thing. Draw your knees in a little bit and start to open. Release the left arm up, taking space, and then pull the fingertips over behind you to the left. And again, you can see my arm is not touching the floor. Eventually, you might come a little deeper, just opening that nice space around the front of the chest. And you can slowly start to engage the arm again before you roll it back. Closing palms, exhale. And then let's do that one more time, pulling the arm up, this time rolling your body over all the way onto the mat, center. Slide your blanket down further now. You're gonna bring it under the sacrum, that little flat area above the glutes and underneath or below the spine. Start to bring your toes onto the mat and tap the right knee towards the shoulder without using your hands. Bring it back, tap, left knee up and towards the shoulder. After you've done that on both sides, bring your hands onto your center and do the same thing, just noticing how your core starts to activate. So we're already creating a little bit of inner strength here, or confronting ourselves rather with our inner strength that is already here. Just have to sometimes remind ourselves that we have it. Tapping toes down, drawing knees in, using your exhale to draw them in. Stepping them back. I like to do one more time, drawing the right knee in, holding on behind the right thigh, interlacing fingers, and now you're going to press the right thigh against the fingers, resisting with the fingers, toes rolling towards you, and then bend the knee, draw it in, release the foot. Back onto the toes, this time left knee one more time into the chest. You're still supported by the blanket, potentially. Interlacing fingers behind the thigh, press the left heel up towards the ceiling. Roll your shoulders down, don't let your shoulders harden, even if you're resisting here with powerful muscle activity. And then bring your feet back, draw your knees into the chest, give your lower back some space, maybe kick your legs up just because it feels good. Take your arms wide, unfold, maybe move your feet, soften your feet here. Bend your knees into the chest, roll over to your favorite side to come up carefully, moving the blanket behind you. You could sit on the blanket or you could sit on the mat for this one. Sometimes it's actually nice to sit on the mat here. Cross your shins, find your shins with your hands. Use your inhale to slowly pull the chest forward like a wave. Exhale, drop the head, round back. Inhale, lifting chin. You don't have to lift it very high if that's too much for your neck. Exhale, roll forward, drop the head. Right, so really go to the edge of that movement. And when I say edge, I don't mean pulling yourself into any maximum space or maximum position as far as you can go, but more like to the edge of the breath. So you let your breath almost guide the movement here, and it becomes a very fluid, smooth transition where you witness your body moving along with your breath. You witness your flexibility, soften your shoulders, bring your arms in front, cross your left arm over the right, bring the back palms together, back of the palms, and tilt your head over to your right ear. Inhale, center, exhale to the left. Do that a couple of times. Inhale, center, exhale to the right, and there's no harm in slowing down. Exhale to the left. Good. And one more time, side to side, and you see I'm, again, not really going as far in as I can. I'm rather just experiencing, exploring. Lift your elbows, inhale, exhale, fold into a soft forward fold here, dropping the head and then releasing your elbows to the side. Pull yourself wide, open chest, draw the shoulder blades together, open the space, and exhale, release your hands onto your knees, drop the chin to the chest, lengthen the neck, and switch the crossing of the shins. Now, from here, we're going to do the other side. So this time, right arm crosses over left. Bend your elbows. Touch the backs of the palms. Press them into each other as now you turn your gaze. Turn your gaze to the right. Inhale, center. Turn to the left. Always coming back to center with the inhale. Always turning away from the center with your exhale. Good. Heavy sit bones, long spine, turning the gaze. Back to center, lift your elbows with your inhale, tilting back, exhale, folding forward, open the back space. And then you can start to draw your elbows wide, open the chest, pull your elbows wide and your shoulder blades together. And as you exhale, you release back onto your knees. Take a breath, take a pause, softening, maybe exhaling a little bit more powerfully here. Now you make your way onto all fours. Let's come into tabletop from here, strong arms. Steady hips, hands right under the shoulders or wider. You can always go wider. Kick the left foot behind you. Lengthen that left leg. Lengthen the neck, pressing out and away from your hands. Step the left foot to the side and walk your hands away from the foot. And I'll show you this one from the front now. So your left leg is long. You walk away from the left foot towards the right, placing the right hand down and see if you can lift the left arm, extend the left arm up as high as you can get it. Now maybe you start drawing circles with that top arm, top hand, could be as big as these, could be smaller. See how your shoulder feels about that. As you stay super strong in your bottom hand, you're really solid in your foundation. You can see I'm looking down towards that hand. Maybe lift up eventually with that left foot. You can start by just tapping. I like to kind of start slow and just move, and then maybe hold it, reach with your hand over your ear, with your leg away, and then in a little bit of momentum, come up, side bending over towards the left from here. Now your left hand goes onto the leg, you draw your right shoulder down towards the left leg, and then you release, gazing over the left leg, left shoulder. Walk your hands back to center. Kick the foot back behind you again. Left leg kicks long behind you. Look down, lengthen the whole back body and cross the left leg over to the right. Bend the knee and extend the knee. So I like to kind of just pulse forward and back a couple of times. Then rounding the spine, setting knee down, doing maybe one cat-cow with your legs crossed here. Yes, just experiencing the space in the whole of the spine with your legs crossed. Good, and then extend the left leg behind you one more time. Lift it and lower the knee down, knees parallel. Any sort of movement that you need here for one breath. Releasing the exhale again. And then kick the right leg behind you. Flexing right foot, toes pointing down and then out. Set the right foot out on your right side. Leg is long. I'll show you again from the front. So the right leg is long. You press into the right foot. You walk your hands away from the long leg towards the left, lifting the right arm up this time and maybe circling that arm. I like to do three. You could do more than that. Of course, you can always do more circles, making sure that your shoulders feel right about that. Reach the arm up, soften the gaze, and then lighten that right leg. And again, I like to start by kind of pulsing that leg up before I come into stillness. So there's nothing rigid about this stillness, just as there's nothing rigid about resilience. Lean up and over, come over to the right side, maybe looking down towards the mat, towards the floor. As you lean into that side stretch, let the shoulder collapse eventually. And then bring your fingertips down in front of the right leg and look over the right shoulder. Looking back, lengthen the neck, pressing into the foot. Take another breath before you come back. Crawl your hands back. And then spin the right leg back behind you. Stretch it out long, again, creating space in the back. Crossing over, bending the knees, shifting the hips back. And a couple of times just bending and extending that leg. Yes, yeah, so just pulsing forward, pulsing back. About three times, and then you're going to lean back, cross the knees all the way, and we're going to go to these rounded cat and cow spines. It's actually just one spine, but it's movements, several movements. So you're going to press out of your palms, rounding, opening, and then extend the leg behind you again, and this time set the knee down, bring the feet maybe tucked, maybe untucked, walk your hands a little further in front so you can drop your chest. And we're going to release the wrists. So as you can see, I'm bringing the backs of my palms together, which gives a nice little release for the wrists. And the hips are the highest point, and you melt your heart down. You create that moment of pause, of recovery as part of the resilience. So at this point, you probably notice that I do want that balance of strength and softness. This is the softness part. Start crawling back, make your way back onto all fours. Come onto your fingertips to step the right foot through. You could use blocks. And I'm starting to use a blanket here for my back knee. You don't have to if you feel fine like this. Leaning into the front knee, knee stays over the ankle, never beyond. And then I bring my right elbow onto my right knee and press both into each other, left hand behind the back. Feel that resistance from both sides. And you could absolutely stay here, pressing into each other, or you could start lifting the back knee off the mat. And then if you do that, you spin the back heel down, opening into a hip opener or a wide stance, warrior two position. Curling up the hips to the side. Now you're opening your arms wide, balancing shoulders over hips. And you could bring your right arm in front, your left arm up. I hope you can see that, reaching over. So now your left arm reaches to the right and your right arm reaches to the left. Again, you face that little bit of resistance and you create resistance even, pulling fingers away from each other before you unfold into a triangle. And when I say triangle, don't think even about touching anything
close to the floor, but instead pulse down. So think more up than down. You're going to align front heel with back arch, and your legs are long but active as you pulse down. Slow pulses, just experiencing the hamstring here, noticing the hamstrings. And then from there, come to stillness, not at the lowest point. Shorten your stance, and we're going to lift up into a half moon. But again, we're going to start by pulsing forward and back. Hopefully, in your case, the blanket is not in the way as it is with me here. Pulsing up and down, and then at some point of that up and down, you might come to halt and stay. Hold that. And you can see I'm not even thinking about going very far with that leg. Step it back. Hold your elbows and right into the transition over to the right. We're going to try and lift the left leg as we're balanced on the right leg. Doesn't have to look like anything, but try to pull your elbows forward. Good. And transition back to solid foundation. Both legs parallel. Shift over towards the left again. Bring your palms down back into the lunge. Lower the knee and step it back into all fours. Now, if this was very fast for you, don't worry. We're going to do it another time. So round, open, side to side, whatever movement you need here with breath. Most importantly, come back to your breath and your exhale. And then step the left foot through, walk up onto the thigh, sink into the hip so you feel the front hip open. It usually feels quite nice if you do it for the first time. Left elbow goes onto the left knee, left thigh. Spread your fingers, bring the right arm behind, and again, find that moment of negotiation between elbow and knee. Tuck the toes under if you like. Lift the knee and spin the back heel down so you come into that warrior two shape, and then lift up all the way into that wide stance, open hips. And from here, we're going to bring this time the right hand in front and the left arm up. So the right fingertips want to go to the left arm wants to go to the right, and we again encountering our resistance. We're pressing two oppositional forces into each other. Unravel, feel the space, walk your foot in a little bit, and then come into that triangle variation where you're sort of pulsing up and down a couple of times. And you're again making super sure that your front leg is active. So you're not sinking into the joint here, pressing into the foot. And if you find a moment of stillness, don't go too far down. Hold that. Step the right foot in a little bit and then see if you can lift it up all the way. And I'm totally leaving the picture frame here. If you can find a little bit of balance, lift the right leg. Eventually, again, it can be a few steps up and down. And then big step back, widen your stance. Take the arms to both sides, hold the elbows, and shift the weight over to the right. Shift the weight onto the right foot, lift the left leg up this time, balancing right on the other side. Good, and turn back forward again. Left leg in front, bring your fingers down to the mat and lower your back knee so you can step it back into all fours. Hardest part is definitely over. Find your breath again. Maybe feel a little bit of movement inside of your body, maybe your blood flow. Maybe you notice your breath is a little bit faster. And we're going to bring it down from here, so make your way onto your belly. Lying down, placing one palm on top of each other, resting the forehead down. And just letting the exhale take more space eventually. So allow for the exhale to slow down. Noticing any challenges that you feel you encountered physically and maybe mentally. Allow for yourself to let go of that. Allow for yourself to soften again using that pause moment. And then bring your hands back onto the mat slowly. And all we're going to do is press into the tops of the feet as we gently roll the chin, the chest, and the rib cage up. And then bringing it down in the oppositional order. So exhale to bring the chin down. Inhale to lift the chin up. Let your chest rise. Let your elbows rise. And this time hold onto your elbows behind the back and do the same thing. Kind of peeling your upper body off the mat very slowly. up and down. And then come to stillness after a few rounds here. Hold it. Keep breathing. Take your hands back down onto the mat and then slide them forward into a cobra pose. Still pressing feet down. You can widen your legs though. Roll the shoulders back, roll the elbows towards you, or isometrically pull them towards you. Turn your head to the left, turn your head to the right. Turn it back to center, lengthen the neck. Keep pulling the elbows back. Notice how you can create resistance with your own body, and then press it up. Come back into all fours, round again after a little bit of back bending. Round, sit back into a really soft child's pose, hands touching the back of the body. Now, if this doesn't work for your knees, you don't have to come all the way down. You could stay up higher. Send a breath or two into your back before you initiate movement again, unfolding into a kneeling position, lifting the arms. And as you exhale, bring the hands behind the back again. And then repeat that. As you inhale, you unfold, you expand, reaching arms up, maybe a slight back bend. Exhale, back of the palms onto the lower back. Folding, reaching up, expanding, exhale, touching backs to the lower back, back of the palms. Good. Then reach your arms up one more time. Inhale, and as you exhale, arms to both sides. Bring your hands down in front of you and swing your shins forward. Make your way into a seated position. Scoot forward on your mat. We're going to do one more wonderful thing that I actually quite like to do. We're going to cross the shins, hold on to the opposite foot, and see if we can extend that foot. Now we're going to lift both heels with our shins crossed, see if we can pull them long, and consciously rolling back, pulling the toes long and rolling up. How much better could the idea of resilience be demonstrated than this? Right? We're falling and we're coming back up, we're recovering. After as many rounds of rolling as you like, you're going to start extending the legs, holding onto the toes. See if you don't fall this time. And if you do, you just come back up. Switch the crossing of the shins, hold the toes from the outside, lift the top shin up, just starting with one leg, just to get the idea. Bending the knee and then going with both heels up. And sometimes takes a moment of mental convincing to roll back and forward again, and then stretch the legs, see if you can avoid to fall, and if you fall, you roll back up again. This is kind of the fun part of this whole practice. And then recross your shins, make your way down onto the mat from here. You might want to roll your blanket for a little support under the knees. You might want to bring your cushion closed so you can rest your head on the cushion, and just take a moment to feel how it is to be back in that shape that we started from. How does that feel? And then you can do any lower back movements that you like. I like to breathe into the belly and exhale, lift the hips a little bit, just a little bit of mobilization for the lower back. Pressing lower back down with the exhale, and then eventually you could go further. For this one, I would like you to remove the cushion though. Lift your hips up into a bridge, keep your knees parallel. Bring your arms down, press the palms down into the mat here. And if you feel like it, set the right foot onto the left thigh. Lift and lower the hips. Now, if this is too much, you just do the same thing in the bridge. We're not going to go very long, so maybe about 3 taps towards the mat, and then lift up, extend the leg. I know this is hard, and then set the foot down and roll it back down to the mat. Take a breath at center. This is the last bit of strengthening, of reminding ourselves of our power. Step the left foot onto the right this time, if you did it on the other side, if you feel ready for it, dipping the hips and lifting them back up. Eventually stretching the left leg towards the ceiling as you press the shoulders down, set the foot down. And with your exhale, roll back down onto the mat. It's time for you to come into your final relaxation. You could have your knees windshield wipering to one side and the other before you go into that relaxation, just for a little bit of release for the lower back area. You don't have to do that. Sometimes it feels very nice. I like to open my arms as I windshield my knees, windshield wiper. I do not know how to make a verb out of that. But you're going to place your hands onto your chest and then maybe bring your pillow back if you had it to prop up your head, prop up your knees. Or if you don't have any of these items, then you're just going to find a way into a very relaxing position on your back. Now, hands on your chest or hands on your belly, allow your body to sink back down into this shape, to rely on the ground. Lie and rely, right? So you have that feeling of heaviness again, of melting, of kind of draping the body onto the surface. And then remind yourself that resilience really is that part, mostly that recovery part, that taking in the benefits of the practice, of the power that you were working with, and all the action that you do all day, action and reaction, all the work that you have to do. This is your moment to recover, to strengthen your resilience. Allowing for your body to sink a little bit deeper, allowing for your breath to come to a very natural pattern, no more active breath. And just listening to yourself here, to your body, to your mind, to your breath. You can stay here for as long as you like, maybe a few more minutes to really take in all of these nourishing parts of this practice. I thank you for practicing with me today, and I hope to see you again soon. Namaste.